Yes. Well, you know, how society values people often determines how people value themselves. Now, there's a long history of African Americans being publicly humiliated, despised. Much of American popular culture for over 100 years used gross caricature of African American faces and culture and ideas and language as a form of comic relief and entertainment through disparagement. Kenneth Clark, a very distinguished sociologist, did a very famous study called the Doll Study, in which he examined young people's responses, young African American people's responses to two different dolls, a white doll and a black doll. And their main job was to determine what they thought was a better doll, which one was smarter, which one was nicer, which one was prettier or more handsome. You know, which doll was generally a better doll on various social characteristics. And many African Americans, despite the fact that they looked much more like the brown skin doll, chose the white doll. Now, there's been controversy. Some say that it was too one-dimensional, but I've noticed some informal studies that have followed up to say that these issues are still operating. And so it's not surprising that if a society doesn't value you very much aesthetically, that you're going to internalize that. Now, again, you have to take into account that the entertainment industry is obsessed with how people look. You have people of all colors, races, genders, changing the way they look to fit a very narrow norm, changing their noses, their chins, their cheekbones, their hair, you know, increasing the size of their lips or shrinking the size of their lips, all depending on where they started out, to create this sense of belonging in the entertainment industry. Now, it's not surprising that if you take the racial element that Jackson might have been facing and you add the entertainment element, you know, it just doesn't surprise me that you would see this substantial, exaggerated response to racial identity.